Students, in this chapter, that is chapter number 6, we are going to study about the statements used in Java, that is Java statements. So in this chapter we are going to cover all this, that is input statements, that is input using buffered reader class, input using scanner class. Okay, we already studied all these in class 9th and 10th. Then next one is conditions. In this conditions, we are going to see relational operators, logical operators, conditional statements, use of default in switch case. Then next one is fall through in switch case. Then we are going to learn about the comparison of if, else and switch case. Then loops and their types. Then block of code, nesting of blocks, scope of a variable, types of loops, infinite loop, empty loop, flag, accumulator, counter, conditions in a loop, loop in a condition, nested loops and jump statements in a loop. So we are going to see one by one. So first one is input statements. So in this session, let us see one of the way to take input of variables of various data types, how to accept the variables like integer variable, double variable, character variable, string variable and boolean variable, etc. So now we are going to see by using a buffered reader class, input using buffered reader class. So in buffered reader class, everything is same. We have to write the class, import, we have to import the package, then we have to write all the variables and their data types, then we have to write buffer reader buff equal to new buffer reader of this. Then how we are going to input? If it is an integer input, we will write integer dot parse int of buff dot readline of. Okay, so if it is a double data type, then you write double dot parse double of this. So if you are accepting a string, then you have to write buff dot read line of. Okay, so if it is a boolean value, then you write boolean dot parse boolean of this. If it is a character, you write character buff dot read of. Okay, to input a string it is read line of, to input a character it is read of. So here we are printing all the values. So these are the inputs and these are the outputs by using input buffer reader. Now we are going to see how to use the scanner class to input the values. So same, you have to write here, you have to create a new object here in the scanner class. So here if you are inputting an integer value, so this will be se dot next int of. If it is a double value, se dot next float of. Okay, now if you are going to accept a string, then it is se dot next line of, object dot next line of. If it is a character, then next line of dot, you have to accept the string and you have to give the position of the character where it is present. Okay, so this how we are able to input the values by using input buffer reader and by using scanner class. Now we are going to see the conditions that we are using in Java. A condition is a statement that helps in decision making. It gives a result of either a true or a false value. Conditions helps to create programs that perform different course of actions when executed with changing set of values each time. First one is relational operators. Okay, so conditions are made using relational operator. There are 6 relational operations. What are the relational operators? Greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, equal to, equal to and not equal to. So this greater than use, we have to compare the value, two values. Less than also we have to compare the two values. The result will be either true or a false. Then greater than or equal to symbol. So here also we are taking two values and checking it. So in this relational operator, the output is either true or in false. The next one is conditional statements. So in Java there are three conditional statements, that is if else and if else, like this it will go. These all are if statement. Then next one is switch case, and third one is ternary operator. So the three conditional statements are if else, switch case and ternary operator. Okay students, now we are going to see how to use the if statement in a program. The program is like this, a program to find the smallest number among the three numbers. So we have to assign three variables and give the values. So if first we have to take the smaller number as A, then we are going to compare this B with the smaller number B with A. So if the condition is true, then smaller number will be B. Okay, like this every time we have to check. Then system.out.println of the smallest number, when the condition which condition is true, then we have to skip out of the loop and print that the smallest number is yes. Okay, so here this is how we are using the if statement for condition checking. The next one is program to check whether the number is odd or even by using if else statement. So if you want to find the given number is odd or even, we have to divide the number to take the modulus of the number, and if the modulus of the number modulus 2 is equal to 0. If the remainder is 0, then it is an even number. If the remainder is other than 0, then it is an odd number. Okay, then next one is, this is the output of that sample program. So else if condition 3, then the block of statements. So here if we are using the else if statement, it consisting of a block of statement. So if the condition 1 is true, then the block of statement 1 gets executed. Otherwise if the condition is true, then the block of statement 2 gets executed, and so on. If none of the conditions are true, then the last else part having final block of statements get executed. The number of condition is optional. Okay, now we are going to see the conditional statement in switch case. So the conditional statement is used in cases where the comparison of it is equality only. So if the switch expression, here we are comparing the case value. So if we give the value as 1, the case value 1 will be executed, then it will stop. If you give 2, the second case will be executed and stop. So it is called as conditional statement. Then use of default statement in switch case. In switch case statement, why we are using the default? So if there are number of cases are there, if we are giving a choice that is not matching with the cases, then at that time it will print a default statement, that is it is a wrong choice. In Java case, Java switch case statement, if none of the cases match, then default becomes active. Default and the block present under it should be appear at last. It is optional. So now we are going to see a program, example program, by using switch case statement. Input a day number and print the corresponding day of the week. Assume that the day begins with Sunday, with day number being 1. Valid day numbers are from 1 to 7. So we are going to display the days one by one. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, like this it will go. Until 7th day we will display. And if we are giving the number as 8, it will display the default statement, that is it is a wrong choice. Okay, so this is the case 1. संडे ब्रेक केस रूल लाइक दिस केस 7 तक हमने लिख दिया तो इफ यू आर गिविंग द केस एज 8 इट विल डिस्प्ले द डिफॉल्ट स्टेटमेंट इट इज द इनवैलिड डे नंबर ओके सो द आउटपुट विल बी लाइक दिस इफ यू आर गिविंग द डे 7 dn equals 7 is a Saturday. If you give the day number as 0, dn equals 0 is an invalid day number. Okay. Now we are going to see the next one, fall through in switch case. Break statement is very important in switch case construct. It helps to terminate a block and to bring the control unit. If block is not given, then all the statement that appears below the matching case get executed. So if the break statement is missing in a switch case, so if you are giving the case number 5 or 4, it will not get a temporary break in case that case number 6. It will continue all the statement after the case 6, case 7, case 8 till it finds a break statement. That is called as a fall through. The following program shows the error of fall through, thus the break statements are missing. See, in this program, case 1, this Sunday, there is no break, case 2, no break, case 3, no break. So there is no break statement is there. That is called as the fall through in switch statement. Okay. So if there is no break is there, if it will ask enter the day in a number. So if you give 5, it will display, first it will display Thursday, then Friday, Saturday, invalid day number. Because there is no break statement here. See, enter the day number 5, dn equal to 5 is Thursday. So it will display dn equal to 5 is Friday, dn equal to 5 is Saturday, dn equal to 5 is an invalid day number. So this is called as a fall through statement in switch case. The next one is comparison of if else and switch case. So you have to learn this tables and compare the value comparison of and study the comparison of if else and switch case. So the next one is conditional statement, that is ternary operator. Ternary operator means we are using three operands with the operator. So in this is the syntax, that is condition, question mark, true zone, then colon, then false zone. Ternary operator is used in cases where the condition is small. So the next one we are going to see the loops and their types. So there are three types of loops that we studied. Already we studied in class 10, that is for loop, while loop and do while loop. So what is called as a for loop? So when we are using this for loop, the number of iterations are known. How many times we have to repeat the same process again and again. That is called iteration. So we know the iterations in for loop. In while loop, when the number of iterations are not known, we are using the while loop. Okay, in do while loop, the number of iterations are unknown. So this for loop is called as an entry control loop, and this while loop and do while loop are called as exit control loop. Okay, so this is the syntax of for loop, and this is the syntax of while loop, and this is the syntax of do while loop. Now we are going to see some examples by using the for loop. So in this for loop, the iteration will repeat up to 15 times and it will do the same process. First p equal to 1, p less than or equal to 15, the condition is true, so it will print the value p, then a space. Okay, because we are using here the print statement, this is for the space. Then p will increment the value by p plus 1, so the value of p is 2, 2 comparing with 15. The condition is true, so it will print the value. Like this, it will repeat the same process 15 times. This is the next example by using the for loop. This is the output of the previous program. So now we are going to see one program by using the while loop. So first, the initial value of p equal to 1. So this will repeat till 15 times. So system dot out dot println of p. First we are printing the value of p, then increment the value, then again we have to compare. So this is also a entry control loop. Okay, we know how many times we have to repeat it. Next, do while loop. First p equal to 1, here we are not checking any conditions. Do first we are printing the value whether the condition is true or false. We are printing the value, then we are increment the value. Again we are checking the value here. If the condition is true, again we will do the iterations again and again. And if the condition is false, when we have to stop the program. So what is the difference between while loop and do while loop? In while loop, it will first check the condition and do the process. First, in the do while loop, first it will do one time iteration, then after it will check the condition. This is the main difference between the while loop and do while loop. So the next one is scope of a variable in a block. So what are the scope of a variable? If a variable is declared inside a block, then its existence is limited to the block. If two variables of the same name can exist, if they are declared in different blocks, the variable declared in the inner block gets priority. Then what are the types of loops? There are several types of loops. First one is infinite loop. Infinite loop means the iterations will go infinite number of times. So this infinite loop, in general error and situation where the loop goes on and on infinite times. See here, k equal to 1, k less than or equal to 20, the condition is true. Then system dot out dot print the value of k. Then there is no increment operator or decrement operator. Again it will go here k equal to 1. So again this will going on like this. There is no conditions, there is no increment, there is no decrement, nothing. So it will going on like this. Okay, so it is called infinite loop. The next one is empty loop. Empty loop means there is no statement inside the loop. That is called as a empty loop. In a loop that does not have any task in it. But an empty loop is not an infinite loop. One application area of empty loop is to wait or to delay. Okay, so this is the program code. Only the loop is there. There is no statement. Nothing is there. And so it is called as an empty loop. So if a for loop is end with a semicolon, then it all is end with a semicolon and it is having some statement, then it is also called as an empty loop. The for loop never end with a semicolon. If a for loop is end with a semicolon and it consisting of statement, then also it is considered as a empty loop. So note, the terminator at the end shows that the loop has no task, thus resulting in an empty loop. Output j equal to 1000. It is an initialized in the statement and then j will not exit outside. Next one is flag. Flag is a kind of variable that is used as an indicator. So the flag consisting of two values, zeros and ones. If it is true, it is one. If it is false, then it is zero. So it assumes the values true or false. For example, set a flag to true if in a group of students a single student has scored full marks. The next one is nested loops. Nested loop is means the loop within another loop. That is called as a nested loop. That is loop inside another loop. When a loop get executed inside another loop, in such cases the inner loop completes its iteration and then the outer loop is incremented. So the programming code given below are the some program codes that below shows how the nested loop works. Okay, so when you see this program number code 1, for r equal to 1, r less than or equal to n, r plus plus. So the next loop we are using here is c. For c equal to 1, c less than or equal to n, c plus plus. So this one is called as the inner loop and this one is called as the outer loop. So if a loop is used within another loop, then it is called as a nested loop. Okay. So the program code number 2 to print the pattern like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So this is the program code. So here we are using two loops, that is R loop and C loop. So the R loop is the outer loop and C loop is the inner loop. So the if two loops, two or more than one loop is used together in a programming code, it is called as a nested loop. Okay. The next one is we have to learn the exercise question answers, true or false, everything, and you have tried to solve all the question answers in the exercise. Okay, then you have to learn all the question answers or exercise question answers. So students, this is the end of this chapter, Java input statement. So whatever book you are finding it as easy, if you are learning all this content in class 9th book, no problem. In class 10th also, 10th book, if you find easier to learn, then you have to learn from that book. If you find this 11th book is comfortable for you, then you have to find the question answers and everything from the book and learn. So this is the end of this chapter, Java statements.